Hello and welcome to another class of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, I will be showing you how the chart applications of Scriptcase work. The chart application uses diagrams to display retrieved information from a database via an SQL select or a procedure. This application has some dynamic resources available to the end user. The chart application generates diagrams such as the bar, column, line, area, circle, pyramid, funnel, radar, gorge, map, dispersion, and even some combinations that can be displayed in a single chart. The data or information displayed between the X and Y axes are defined via dimension that displays specifically what is being compared to, while the metrics represents the discrete values. The metrics and dimensions can both be configured using the drag and drop area. When creating a new chart, I need to first define the dimensions and metric fields. So let's go ahead and create a new chart application, selecting chart, and then I can select the table for which I want this chart to work. So here I will go ahead and select the orders table, for instance, and go ahead and click the create button when ready. When creating a new chart, I need to first define the dimension and metrics fields. I have this area here where I can drag and drop the fields into the available definition. So here I will drag the shipping country into the dimension, and for the metrics, let's go ahead and just add a record count. Now, if I set more than one dimension, the chart will automatically enable the drill down function, where you can then navigate from a chart to another chart or even grid with more relevant details of the required information. The new chart can be opened overwriting the same chart. It can be displayed below the first chart, or it can also be opened in another window. As you can see here within the dimensions, I have here the ship country. Once I've added it, I have next to that a checkbox. If the checkbox is checked, it means that Scriptcase will load it by default. If it is not checked, Scriptcase will not display the field. However, the field will be available to the end user to change the dimensions and metrics dynamically. So I'll go ahead and add another dimension, and then we can see that the checkboxes are there, and I can deselect and select them, as well as remove the dimensions by clicking the X in the right hand corner. Okay, so let's go ahead and run the chart application and see what it looks like just with this dimension and single metric. So as we can see here, we have here the basic chart. We have a header, we have sorting options, which are dynamic, as well as a custom button next to that, where we can change the metrics which are available. Of course, these metrics need to be defined by the developer. Next to that, we have some further buttons which allow us to change the type of chart which we are currently viewing. We have there the line chart, an area chart, a pie chart, as well as other charts when relevant or further information is available for the chart. We then also have a button called chart types. Clicking that will allow us to view the various charts available, as well as a graphical display of what they would look like. Next to that is the summary, which displays then the summarization of all dimensions added to the chart. To the right, we have an export button where we can then export the chart to PDF, Word, Excel, and so forth, all of which can be configured within Scriptcase as we had done so previously for the form or for the grid application. So let's return back to Scriptcase again, and I'm going to go ahead and add some further dimensions. So now I have the ship country, region, as well as the city added. So before I go ahead and run that, I'm going to view the sorting, which allows us then to customize the sorting values if they should be ascended, descended, as well as the metrics that can be displayed for each dimension added. The next tab provides us the search field. Here again, we can drag and drop the relevant fields into the container. And then on the right of that, we have some various options which allow us to customize the search further. The next tab available is the chart tab. Here we can customize the type of chart that is being viewed. For instance, I will now change this to a 3D column instead of a 2D column. We have export features. We can change the font size, apply a subtitle, display values, as well as change the width and height of the chart. So I'll go ahead and run the chart again, and we should now have the multiple dimensions available within the chart which we have just added. Now, clicking on one of the values will provide us now with a drill down feature. It is important that we have multiple dimensions within the chart to enable this drill down feature, and I should mention again that we can dynamically change the information for the chart displayed. Clicking on the custom button, we can now see the various dimensions which we have added. There is also the option to enable or disable the drill down feature. Each of these dimensions dimensions can then be added or removed on the fly. When deselecting the use drill down instead of grouping areas, notice that the multi-chart or stacked chart option becomes available. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.